Journal entry 271. We made it to the plains and got close enough to observe the situation. The barbarian war camp was in shambles. Panic everywhere. It looked like they were recovering from artillery, although they were out of spells and catapult range. It was total chaos. Then we found the cause. There was a loud bang, audible from where we were, and a second later, an explosion erupted in the middle of the barbarian ranks. It was artillery. Jason confirmed that was fired from Winterfield. Mortars. A few minutes later, another one fired. After several shellings, the barbarians finally pulled into a retreat, heading in the direction of their supply camp. We held our position on the hill. An hour later, the front gates of Winterfield opened and their militia stepped out. It looked like they were scavenging the barbarian camp for supplies. People started coming out to join them. Some were fighting over what food they could get. We decided to pull back and move into our old crypt base for the time being. We'll let them recover a bit before they decide to steal everything of ours because they're starving. This begs the question, who introduced mortars to Winterfield? The same person who's sending cannon material to Wolf Lake? More questions. Journal entry 272. We let things set for a few days, then we rode out to the city. The gates were opened and there was a large watch out front. A group of civilians were digging a mass grave to hold a large mound of corpses nearby. Other than that grisly sight, things were looking less desperate. Upon approach, the guard out front drew their weapons. We stopped and explained ourselves. That we were adventurers and what we've been doing out here against the barbarians. We were given clearance to enter, but warned that food was on short supply. Doesn't look like we're going to get our hot meal. They also mentioned that the provisional government is hiring mercenaries to bolster their armed forces for the upcoming actions against the barbarians. We noticed, upon entering, a brand new mortar sitting within the walls. Only one. It was surrounded by some guards and what looked like an alchemist. We tied up our horses and went over to talk to them about it. They wouldn't let us get near the thing. State secret. I did get a quick glimpse into their minds. Nothing that would point them out as Terrans. I would need to get a longer session to find out where the gunpowder came from. It can't be from Wolf Lake Orcs. And how would it have gotten here? We're going to check in to this better tonight if we can. Jason paid a visit to his guild. We met him later at the graveyard. We paid our respects to Amanda's gravesite. Avery said a prayer for her. Then we checked into our inn and paid with a loaf of bread, which is worth more than gold right now,